The burning of 20,000 books in Berlin's Bibelplatz on 10th of May 1933 marks the rise of the Nazi Party and the ascent of Adolf Hitler. Though the Nazis had a firm grip on Germany and later on much of Europe, not all Germans were Nazis, nor did they all support Hitler. In fact, there was a very real resistance to him within Germany. Hello, I'm Philip von Schultes, and my grandfather, Claus von Stauffenberg, was the military leader of the resistance group that attempted to assassinate Adolf Hitler and take charge of government on 20th of July 1944 in a plot known as Operation Valkyrie. I'd like to take you on a tour of some of the important locations in my grandfather's life. Behind me, you see contemporary Berlin. Join me now as I take a look back in time at the Berlin of 1944.
Members of the aristocracy naturally became resistors out of a sense of honor, because many of them were outraged by the crimes that were being committed by the regime. And when the mass killings started, they had to draw a line.
I'm walking on Tristanstrasse in Wannsee, Germany. Wannsee was a wealthy suburb of Berlin and home to Nazis, senior military officers, as well as my grandfather. Claus von Stauffenberg was not a member of the Nazi Party. He lived in this house behind me with his brother Berthold. His family, wife Nina and the four children, lived in Bamberg, which was a fortunate move because Bamberg was one of the few cities not to be destroyed in World War II. At the time of the plot against Hitler, Nina was pregnant with their fifth child, my mother Constanze. Today, this home is subdivided into four different units. And on the street outside, there's a plaque acknowledging that this is the one-time residence of Claus von Stauffenberg. Now a museum, this was my grandfather's office. It is in the heart of Berlin, on a street that was once called Bendlerstrasse. Co-conspirator General Friedrich Olbricht, one of Stauffenberg's superiors, had an office in the same building. And I've often wondered how many times they must have frantically crossed these corridors on July the 20th while their plan was slowly slipping away from them. The resistance couldn't meet openly or in public, nor could they discuss their plans in their offices for fear of being discovered. So they met in private residences, amongst them this house in Potsdam. The home was owned by the von der Lancken family. The children were told to stay away from this part of the house as the conspirators met. But one surviving daughter, Maria Antonia, has her own tale to tell of the secret meetings and of what she remembers.
Mein Vater hat eingeladen die Offiziere vom OKH, unter anderem General Olbricht, Stauffenberg, und die waren öfters Gäste bei meinem Vater zum Abendessen. Und wir Kinder, Stauffenberg besonders imponiert, weil er eben eine Augenklappe hatte und schwer verletzt war vom Krieg aus Afrika, dass der als erstes, was er tat, wenn er bei uns reinkam, sämtliche Kissen nahm und aufs Telefon packte. Und als wir abends später oder am nächsten Tag meine Eltern fragten, warum er das tat, beziehungsweise mein Vater sagte, na, der hat nur Angst gehabt, dass er vielleicht irgendwie abgehört wird. Deshalb hat er das auf Telefon gelegt.
The fear of the knock on the door at 5 in the morning and the fear of anyone wearing a leather coat, the sense that the Gestapo were everywhere and a system of spying of people on each other that was encouraged and was in fact instituted by the Nazis. There were very large apartment complexes. There were people appointed to spy on the tenants and to report anything unusual that they noticed. And if somebody had said, I don't like this war or something, off into concentration camp they would go.
This is the spot where at one time the bomb was kept hidden. Of course, Adolf Hitler survived the assassination attempt. And with Operation Valkyrie having failed, Stauffenberg's immediate superior, General Friedrich Fromm, issued an order to have him executed at once. It was on this courtyard below me that my grandfather was executed in the early hours of July 21st, 1944, along with three other conspirators.
Those were the first executions, which were very unpopular with the justice and police authorities, because there had been no opportunity to interrogate. But in the first 2 to 3 weeks, about 700 people were arrested in connection with the conspiracy. Their names had been found on lists or in notebooks or had otherwise been known or betrayed in some cases.
The People's Court was set up by Hitler to try those accused of political offenses. It was overseen by Dr. Roland Freisler. No real trials took place behind these walls. In fact, historians consider them nothing more than mock trials, which resulted in everyone involved, or rumored to be involved, in a July 20th conspiracy to be found guilty. They were all sentenced to death.
The first trial was held on the 7th and 8th of August, and they were instructed to prosecute cases of political offenses, subversion, defeatism.
In a twisted bit of irony, Freisler was killed in his own courthouse when he was hit by Allied bombing on 3rd of February 1945. At the time, he was hearing the case of Fabian von Schlabrendorf, one of the conspirators. Freisler was struck by a ceiling beam and killed. The bombing effectively saved Schlabrendorf's life. Schlabrendorf was subsequently sent to various concentration camps and was liberated by US forces in May of 1945. In Valkyrie, I play the part of Schlabrendorf. The Plessensee prison is where those convicted in the People's Court were executed for their participation in a July 20th plot. Today, it is a memorial to the victims of the Hitler dictatorship. It is documented that 89 people involved in the plot were executed in this room. Amongst them, Claus von Stauffenberg's brother, Berthold. Rumors have long existed that they were hung from piano wires to make their deaths more painful, and that Hitler regularly watched film of their executions.
The first 8 executions on the 8th of August and a dozen subsequent executions were in fact filmed, and Hitler did watch filming of the hangings. And I have spoken with people, including former munitions minister Albert Speer, who confirmed that stills from the films were on Hitler's map table.
Thirty-five years after the war, the German government established a memorial to the resistance movement. A plaque and wreath hang on the wall near where my grandfather was executed. There is also a museum here that documents the resistance movement during World War II in Germany. And Stauffenbergstrasse is the name of the street that was once known as Bendelstrasse. I'm Philipp von Schultes. Thank you and goodbye.